guess I'm going to walk. Oh, that milky white way. Oh, child, some of these days. Well, I'm going to walk that milky white way. Oh, some of these days. Well, 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 I'm going to walk up and take up my stand. Gonna join that Christian band. I'm going to walk, whoa, that milky white way. Oh, Lord, some of these days. I'm gonna tell my, oh, my mother, howdy, 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 when I get home. Yes, I'm going to tell my mother, howdy, when I get home. Well, 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 I want to tell my mother, hey, when I shake mother hand that day. That's when I walk, oh, that milky white way. Some of these days. I want to meet God the Father and God the Son. Yes, I want to meet God the Father.
To life, so that in our fertility, God. We know that you are a mighty God. We know that all things is in your hand. Thank you for this opportunity to come together and celebrate our homegoing. We praise God for you. We honor you with your blessings.
Him to have done.
dominion over the works of thy hand. Thou hast put all things under his feet, all sheep and oxen, yea, and the beasts of the field, the fowl of the air, and the flesh, and the fish of the sea, and whatsoever passes through the paths of the sea. O Lord, our God, how excellent is thy name. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful.
Where I am that he may be.
Jesus, him. Lord, we know not whither thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me.
Yes, sir.
And we'd like to say good morning this morning. We thank God for the opportunity to celebrate another homegoing. And we praise God for the Trinity he's a part of, the Father, the Son, and the precious Holy Ghost.
Amen.
And to all of you in your respective places, to the pastor of this great church in his absence, to all the other pastors and ministers and dear to for his gospel's sake, for his sisters and brothers, and to our family, amen, and friends,
mm-hmm.
and to all well wishers that come to make up their congregation, we greet you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We celebrate the life for an 11 memory of Thomas Lawrence Corder, July 28, 1956 to September 27, 2024. This is a homegoing service.
Yeah.
I know your heart is made to bleed and tears will fall from your eyes, but there's nothing wrong with crying, because crying is a release system.
All right.
But we must know that it's a better place, because joy comes in the morning. We know that we want to celebrate this morning.
Right.
And we are here, and the family and to and respect and honor of our funeral staff, J.W. Williams funeral staff, and all the workers here, amen, they have come together with this family,
mm-hmm.
and they have so gracefully made a obituary, something that we can follow and do things decent and in order.
All right.
Do I have a witness here? And I'm glad that God is a God of order. Amen. And not only of order, he's an author of peace.
That's right.
And in your obituary, it has order of service. And it has so much, we don't want to do anything that's incorrect. And if anything is incorrect, you don't take it to the heart, to my head, don't take it to my heart, take it to my head, because I have an order of service twice. Amen. If you see that, open it up. Now, I'm going to make sure, and hopefully, that this order of service has the same outline as individuals coming and being a part of this order of service. And that's why I'm going to go down the order of service and make sure that everything is done decent and in order. It says here, order of service, I'm going to read this one here because it's an insert. Amen. If I'm allowed to. And most of all, if it ain't Jesus, don't answer that phone. Amen. Please don't answer that phone. Amen. Amen. If you have any, you know it, clap your hand. Okay. Yeah. I'm reading the insert. Amen. And it's not, if anything that needs to be corrected, please do so for the respect and wishes of the family. Amen. It says order of service. I'm going to read everything. And I'm going to sit down. I'm not going to get up anymore. It says musical prelude. Then it says minister of music. Then it says procession, led by yours truly. The final viewing, the final closing of the casket. That has already been done. Thank you, J.W. Funeral Home and staff. Now, we have individuals who are going to come and share with us in our celebration. Won't you say amen?
Amen.
Hymn and prayer, Deacon Frank Mays.
I got Deacon Owen to prayer.
Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Hymn, prayer. So we have the hymn by Deacon Frank Mays, and we have the prayer by Deacon Willie Owens. Scripture reading, Old Testament, Reverend Willie, Pastor Ed Walker. New Testament, Minister Lee Wright. Then we will go on into the celebration with a musical selection. Kristen Porter and Yvette, thank you. Because that's sometimes that why I sound like an E. Amen. Yvette Porter, thank you. And next we'll have a poetic tribute. Madeline Porter. Then musical selection, Sister Dorothy McCray. Then we have the Word of God, the eulogy. Amen. For the word of comfort. Amen. Pastor Garry Baker. And then we will have the JW Funeral Home staff come back and give us other directions for where we're going to go from there. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let's hear. Amen. Hymn and pray. Amen.
We are down here, Lord, and we are praying on you, Lord.
We got some help in the deep hole. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Well, that's my story calling, but I ain't claiming it because God is able.
Yeah.
13 verse, but it says, "But I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep,
yes,
that ye sorrow not,
yes,
even as others which have no hope.
Yes.
For we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them which are asleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep.
That's right.
For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, mm-hmm. with the voice of the archangel,
that's right.
and with the trump of God. Mm-hmm. And the dead in Christ shall rise first. Mm-hmm. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall ever be with the Lord. Wherefore we comfort one another with these words. May the reading of God's word be a blessing to his people.
Amen.
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 So what you gonna do now? We're gonna carry on. One day, a long time ago, I planted my soul, and I found that the soil changed very often. Once it was love, oh, that proved to be harmful. Once it was nature, that proved to be excellent, but just not quite steady enough for so important a task. Once, it was myself. But I don't know myself well enough. One content time, it was God. It was really God all along, but I knew it not. One day, a strong wind or something came and knocked my pot of soil over with my soul still in it. I was spread out over a vast area and I was grief-stricken. But some kind being, probably God again, came and replanted my soul for me. And with every pat of the soil and every drop of water, God uttered the word, stay alive. And I did. I went down to the river. I sat down on the bank. I tried to think, but I couldn't. So I jumped in and I sank. I came up once and I hollered. I came up twice and I cried. If that water hadn't been so cold, I might have jumped and died. But it was cold in that water. It was so cold. Life is fine. Life is fine. So live your life to the fullest, because that's what Thomas would have wanted us to do, because your world is as big as you make it. I know. For I used to abide in the narrowest nest in a corner with my wings pressed close to my side. But I sighted the distant horizon with a skyline encircled the sea, and I throbbed with a burning desire to travel this immensity. I battered the cordons around me and spread my wings on the breeze, then soared to the uttermost reaches, with rapture, with power, with ease. I love you, Thomas. I'll see you later. Thank you.
present to you and ask you this song. Pastor Garry. And here Paul is speaking these words, and another scripture referenced in which Brother Lee already read 1 Thessalonians chapter 4.
All right.
In which they read very similar.
All right.
In this verse. It says in verse 51.
All right.
Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall be all changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible is put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So, when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. And then, just a portion of passage there in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 says in 14, for if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. And then the very last passage, in verse 18, it says,
Wherefore,
comfort one another with these words.
Amen.
The word of God for the people of God.
Yeah.
I want to just talk from this subject for a few minutes.
Yes.
About the good news of the gospel. The good news.
Good news.
Of
the gospel.
The gospel.
My God. Preach.
All of us know what it's like to receive good news.
Yes. Yes.
As well, all of us know what it's like to receive bad news. And I want to submit to you today that the Bible gives us the notion to know that the gospel, the word of God, is good news.
Amen.
Matter of divine.
Come on.
Word gospel itself.
It's good.
It means good news.
Good news, man. Speak.
Well, when they ask the question, what is so good about the gospel? All
right. What is so good?
What is so good about the gospel? You know, my brothers and sisters, if you want to understand what is good about the good news about the gospel, you need to reflect upon the bad news.
Amen.
The reason why the gospel is good news is because indeed there was bad news.
Amen.
That Adam failed in the garden.
Yes.
Sin entered the world.
Yes.
And there was no continuity, communication between God and man, his creation.
Amen. All right.
Man had fallen.
Amen.
And down through history, as you look at the Bible from the Old Testament, which is the Old Testament itself, is a story about God's faithfulness.
All right.
It's the story of God's faithfulness as he seeks to bring his people back to him, to reconcile his people unto himself.
Amen.
So that was the bad news. We were cut off from God. We were damned to hell.
Amen.
But God took the initiative himself.
Amen.
This is the good news, y'all.
Amen.
God took the initiative himself.
Amen.
That we all can be reconciled back to him.
Amen.
I think I need to stop here and put a pause. And I was intending to say this at the beginning, but I think this is a good point to slide it back in.
Amen.
When I think about a funeral, we come together, funeral, we come for at least four reasons.
Mm-hmm.
For at least four reasons.
All right.
I'm not giving any particular order.
Uh-huh.
But when we come, one of the reasons is we consider two realities.
Reality.
We consider life's reality.
Mm-hmm.
And that is, this is the only setting, my brothers and sisters, where we come and we sit and these two realities come together, the reality of life and the reality of death. Right here together.
Right together.
And so the question is, to us, you and I that are alive, is how are we going to live our lives? Or it is. That's a pertinent question. How are we going to live our lives?
Mm-hmm.
So whatever we need to do,
yes,
we need to give that some consideration. The second reason is to celebrate the life of Brother Thomas.
Amen.
You that knew him well, brothers and sisters and daughters and cousins, you all knew Brother Thomas.
Amen.
And friends. And we celebrate his life. I'm sure he has impacted many in so many different ways. Not only do we celebrate his life, but we come to have a point of closure. Because I would say ritually, the closing of the casket, in some way, it communicates closure.
Amen.
Now, it doesn't mean that you're not going to miss Brother Thomas. It doesn't mean that your heart is not going to ache. But it is a point of you close, it brings about closure.
Amen. Yes.
I know many that they skipped having a funeral celebration and they come later in life to regret it.
Amen.
Because somehow they didn't get that point of closure, and our being here is a part of that process.
Right.
And then the fourth reason is to my brother and sister, is to commune with God.
Amen.
Yes, we come to worship God today.
Amen.
Yes, we come to worship God.
Amen.
So here, in the whole scheme of the gospel, the fact that God took the initiative that we may be reconciled unto him. So that says to all of us that every human being has an opportunity to be saved. Every human being have an opportunity to be saved.
Yeah. Yeah. Uh-huh. Come on.
And when you look at the gospel says to us that Jesus came.
Amen.
Jesus died.
Yes. Yes.
Jesus was buried.
Yes.
And he rose again.
Uh-huh.
And the Bible says that if we believe that,
yes,
if we believe that truth in life, that Jesus, he died and he was buried and he rose again, what did it say? Thou shalt be saved.
Amen.
That's how simple it is.
Yeah.
And since we're talking about gospel, let me just throw this in here, my brothers and sisters. The gospel really means that we are to respond to what Jesus has done. Respond to what God has done. Can I help somebody here?
Amen.
That you got to understand.
Amen.
That once you are saved, I'm talking about saved now.
Amen.
You're always saved.
Amen.
And there's nothing that can pull you away from the Lord. I said, once you're saved. But you know, many of us have a problem with that because we're in this Western culture. We know we like to work and we get paid. We work. You get paid for what you do. But that's not God's economy. Understand me, my brothers and sisters.
Right.
You and I cannot do enough
Amen.
To warrant the favor of God.
Amen.
That's why God took the initiative to send his son Jesus to die for our sins. Because none of us could do anything to save ourselves. And I think I need to tell you, none of us can do enough to keep ourselves safe.
Amen.
Or somebody ought to get happy about that.
Amen.
None of us
come on.
Can do enough,
enough.
To even keep yourself safe.
Yes.
No, that doesn't mean that you got license to go run buck wild. No.
No.
Think that perhaps you just really haven't been saved.
Amen.
Do I have a witness here?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
My brothers and sisters, the gospel, mm-hmm. is Jesus, death, burial, and resurrection.
Uh-huh. Yes.
You know, in our church, the Baptist church and many other churches, you know, there's two ordinances.
Right.
And those ordinances, uh-huh. how ordinance is established is that as we observe it, it always, the very act points back to his death, burial, and resurrection.
Amen.
When a person is baptized, it's symbolic to one being buried in the water.
Amen.
Submerged and then coming up.
Amen.
And that represents my brothers and sisters, one as they as they have, they identify with the death, burial, and the resurrection of Christ. They died,
amen.
Buried in the water, and rose again in newness of life.
Yes, sir. Great.
When you observe the Lord's Supper, that has written on the table, this do in remembrance of me.
Yeah.
It points back to his death, burial, and resurrection.
Yes, sir. Great.
All my brothers and sisters, that's the gospel.
Yeah.
I just said two Sundays ago to our church that, you know, Paul says that when we observe the Lord's Supper, we proclaim his death.
Amen.
Till he come.
Amen.
Until he return.
Yes, sir.
And that word proclaim means, it means to preach.
Amen.
So every time we come and we observe the Lord's Supper, we are preaching.
Uh-huh.
We're proclaiming his death until
he comes.
My brothers and sisters, that is good news.
Good news.
Here in the gospel.
Yes.
It's good news because of the proclamation.
Yes, sir.
Don't you hear what Paul said earlier in the text in 1 Corinthians? He said, I'm giving you what was given unto me.
Yes. Amen.
He said, this was given to me, that verse 3. He says, for I deliver unto you, first of all, that which I also received, and how that Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures.
Amen.
He says that this gospel is, it must be proclaimed. He said, I'm proclaiming it unto you.
Uh-huh. Yes.
It is a proclamation. You remember that when Jesus had burst upon the scene and the angel went to the shepherds that was keeping their flock. Mm-hmm. And there the angel said to them, be not afraid.
Amen.
Be of good cheer.
Yes, sir.
Come to bring you good tidings.
Yes.
And proclaiming,
yes,
giving a message.
Amen.
And secondly, not only that's proclamation, but can I tell you, there's power.
Power.
Amen.
You want to know,
yes,
about the gospel? The gospel, there is power.
Power.
Paul said in Romans chapter 1, around verse 16, thereabout, he said that I'm not ashamed of the gospel.
Yeah.
For the gospel is the power of God unto salvation.
Yeah.
Oh, if you want to be saved,
oh, yeah,
receive the gospel.
Receive the
gospel. I've already told you, it's not about what you do.
Yeah.
It's not based on your performance or your behavior.
Yeah.
But it's based on what the Lord has done for us.
Yeah.
All the thing we do is accept.
Yes.
What he so freely give.
Yes.
The power unto salvation.
Yes.
And then I can tell you, my brothers and sisters, the third thing, mm-hmm, I want to leave you with, that the gospel is good news because of the promise.
Amen.
Because of
the promise.
The promise. You know, every child of God ought to get happy.
Amen.
Even when we think about when our life is coming to a close.
Yeah. Yes.
Because one thing that we know, that death is not the end.
Amen.
Right. Death is a beaten foe.
Yes.
Or yes, death is not,
yes,
the end.
Yes.
That's why Brother Lee had said it in reading 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. No wonder he said, comfort one another with these words.
Words.
Why? Because my brothers and sisters, death is a beaten foe.
Yes.
Death is not the end.
Amen.
It has been said, death is just like going. It's just like life is just like going to school.
Yes.
And death is our commencement.
Yes.
Do I have a witness here?
Amen.
You know, some folks think that with commencement, they think that that's the end. But no, commencement means it's a beginning.
Yes,
sir.
Amen.
It's,
yes,
a new beginning.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Oh, yes, life is just like planting the crop.
Yes, sir.
But that is the harvest time.
Yes.
Can I get a witness here?
Yes, sir.
Oh, yes. Life is just like working on a job.
Yes, it is.
But death is our promotion.
Promotion. Yes, sir.
Oh, you want to get excited?
Yes, sir.
Because the gospel tells us of the promise that as children of God, we all shall have eternal life.
Yes, sir.
Do I have a witness here?
Yes, sir.
Over in Africa.
Yes.
One of the practices there of the African, the Christian Africans, mm-hmm, is that when their loved one is deceased,
uh-huh, yes,
they do not say, like we customarily say, that our loved one has departed.
Well.
They don't use that language in that circle. They do not say, my loved one has departed.
Yeah.
But rather, they would say, our loved one has arrived.
Yeah.
I do not have a witness there.
Yes, yeah.
And can I tell you today, my brothers and sisters, that Brother Thomas has arrived.
Yeah.
Oh, come on, help me if you will.
Yeah.
One know the Lord in the part of that season.
Yes,
when death comes, they have arrived. to eat the hog. But don't worry about me. Soon one morning, King is gonna put one foot on the sea and on the land. He gonna sound the trumpet, and the Bible declares that something's gonna happen. I tell you, the eagle got to give up the hawk.
It is hard to realize, but yet it is true, that the battle for God's prize must go on without you. But you finished your task the other day. You folded up your tent and you went away. You left us. Yes, you left us. And while you cannot come back to us, we are glad we can come to you. For the record will show that you died the other day, but from the record will show you're just away. The family of Mr. Thomas Lawrence Porter is most appreciative for the many kind and loving expressions of sympathy you have shown. They ask for your continued prayers in the days to come, and may each of you continue the blessings of the Lord. The following care arrangements have been sent to the family. Our sincere condolences for your loss. Thomas will surely be missed. Love, Gail and family. To Christian Porter, we love you from Evening Star number 228. In loving memory of Mr. Thomas, who will be missed by his family, the Porter family. The family flower is given in loving memory of a loving and caring father, uncle, brother, and friend from the family. In loving memory of Dr. Napoleon Williams, Deacon Arthur L. Parker, CEO and President, along with staff of J.W. Williams Funeral Home, is pleased to present to this family an African-American family heirloom Bible, in the hope that it will serve as a source of added comfort and peace in the days to come. It is our prayer that you're blessed now and always.